Have you guys heard of CERN? What is it? Have you heard of CERN?
CERN.
I've seen it around, but I don't know. Is that about the, I don't know, like...
It's like in Switzerland. It's like underneath the ground. It's like 17 miles long. And it's like this, they're trying to open up a portal and they did it in 2012. And people are saying that's what the cause of the Mandela effect. And they're turning it back on July 5th. And they're turning it on at the most power it's ever been on. And they're supposedly doing it on July 5th because that's when people will be like, it's after July 4th, after people are drinking. And I don't know. It's kind of creepy. I've looked it up on.
Yeah.
Just look up. If you just go on Twitter and just type in like CERN July 5th, you'll see people talking about it.
Well, that's terrifying. So when we start noticing weird stuff is changing and we're like, hold on, I thought it was this.
Are they literally all going
to
know?
Home Depot or the Home Depot? Or just like they're saying it has to do with the Mandela effect. And then you think about
the Mandela effect.
You never heard of the Mandela effect? Oh, man.
No. Does it have anything to do with Nelson?
Yes. It's basically where people have collective memories of things being different. So
yeah. Like the Berenstain Bears.
Exactly. Yeah. That is exactly what I was going to bring up. But it's like a whole bunch of people are like, no, I remember it being this. Also, Shazam is another one. What's his name being in Shazam? What the hell?
Shaq?
Shaq? Or is it Sinbad? It was one of them. That people are like, no, he was in Shazam, but he's like, I've never been in that movie. So like weird stuff like that, but it's a whole bunch of people that have the exact same memory. That's so it's so not just funny. One person. It's like everybody. It's collective.
What does one do to prepare for the CERN then?
Me and Lila were, yeah.
It's just happening on July 5th. And okay, yeah, see, it's like, it's scientific, like it's a lab.
But clearly it's happening whether we protest or not. So it's like, what do you even do?
And they're trying to, it's going to, I don't know. They say it's
just like,
okay, here, listen to this lady talk about it. She's a scientist.
This one?
Yeah.
She's, you know what? She's a redhead. I trust her.
She kind of looks like you in a weird way.
July into your calendars because this is the day when the Large Hadron Collider will start colliding particles at the highest energy we've ever done.
One of CERN's goals is to recreate Jacob's Ladder and to reopen a portal that is said to have existed between Earth, Mars, Venus, and Saturn when the planets were in alignment many years ago.
Don't you people have enough to do?
CERN are pretty sure that other dimensions do, and they're making it their goal to ensure that they open the portal for their use. Who knows? Out of this door might come something. Or we might send something through it. Now, prophecy in numerous parts of the Bible refer to a coming day when portals will be opened and spiritual entities are going to pass through and come to the earth.
Get ready for timeline shifts, Mandela effects. You're about to see a lot more than you've ever seen.
Start looking for a lot of different type of Mandela effects. Vortexes in the sky, things of that nature.
Ugh.
They're going to restart CERN at the highest energy levels ever in that reactor. They believe that it split the time continuum back in 2012, hence all the Mandela effects since then.
Why am I getting news on TikTok?
Well, that's great. So we're giving up, right, on just everything? Cool.
Do we still have to do laundry? Will this thing like change your sheets for you?
That would be nice. If it did that, I'm here for it.
Oh my God. This is scary. Chat, have you heard of this?
People are like writing, I am concerned.
Yeah, this is what happens when you tell us to stop talking about pus and blood.
Then we start thinking. Nobody wants us thinking. Come on.
Enjoy our thoughts.
Good for anyone.
Okay, so I'm going to say how to prepare for CERN.
One of the things that Lila was saying was what were you saying about sobriety?
Well, it's just like they're doing it on July 4th. It's because a lot of people will be drinking and partying. And that's how they'll be able to, it's better if you just be sober on July 5th when this is going on.
So July 4th, we can be drunk.
Yeah. July 5th.
When the clock strikes midnight.
When they activate it, just, you know.
Start drinking water at like 11 p.m. Hey, Penn Bar, this talk about CERN reminds me of the Montauk Project from MKUltra. Oddly enough, I think Stranger Things was inspired by the MKUltra Project. Oh, absolutely.
Oh, I got to look into that. I'm not
aware. It's all like MKUltra. Celebrity mind control shit. Like anybody who's really famous is MKUltra. Like Britney, Gaga, and like once you start learning like what the hallmarks are of the mind control, you start seeing it in a lot of celebrities. Katy Perry is a big one.
And Prince.
Okay, wow. I gotta look into
personal.
This.
That's personal. I think my aunt was like involved with that.
Really?
And yeah.
Cool. Thanks, Spectral.
And it was a whole thing with Prince too.
Did your aunt work for Hollywood?
No, I think that she was one of the kids that they experimented on. They had like celebrities and kids come together. It was really weird. Like they'd have a celebrity marry a child. It was super weird.
Ew.
And of course nobody like really believes these people, because afterwards they're like, they have schizophrenia and bipolar and they're completely messed up.
I wonder why.
Yeah, they're so messed up after all of this. But it's
holy shit. Is she okay now?
Creepy. No. she has schizophrenia and bipolar and all of this stuff. But
maybe it was the haunted doll.
Probably.
Holy shit. Carmaxlla, it's like with Carmaxlla, a conversation is just like you're just tipping over rocks and you're like, oh my god, all these worms.
I know, I love every story she tells. I'm always like, hold on, what?
Yeah. I love it.